குட் மார்னிங், குட் ஈவினிங் ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ். ஒன்ஸ் அகெய்ன் ஐ எம் ஹேப்பி டு மீட் யூ த்ரூ தி லெக்சர் ஆன் தி சப்ஜெக்ட் ஆப்ரேஷன் ரிசர்ச். டுடே தி லெக்சர் நம்பர் 2 ஆன் மாடியூல் 1. த டைட்டில் ஃபார் தி லெக்சர் இஸ் ஃபார்முலேஷன் ஆஃப் எல்பிபி. ஸோ எல்பிபி ஸ்டாண்ட்ஸ் ஃபார் லீனியர் ப்ரோக்ராமிங் ப்ராப்ளம். So we just recap. So what we discussed earlier in the first lecture. So we have defined operation research and we have discussed the phases of operation research, particularly construction of the mathematical model. So what do you mean by the construction of mathematical model? We have to convert any physical problem into mathematical equations. Consisting of algebraic equation for operations research. And we discussed the advantages of operation research, disadvantages, the area of application, scope of operation research, and the various limitations of operation research. So these are all the topic, but particularly which is important here is the construction of mathematical model. So in the basics of introductory lecture, I introduce one component called the construction of model under the phases of OR, which means converting the physical problem, converting the problem into a set of mathematical equations which can be solved. And today, in this lecture, we are going to discuss what is linear programming problem, what are the requirement of linear programming problem, and how to formulate the linear programming problem from the definition. And to understand the concept, we will have example problem, and by solving the example problem, you may understand how to formulate a linear programming problem. So the linear programming problem was invented in 1947 by George Danstein. I told the entire subject operation research was evolved during the Second World War. So it is a period. So if you have a linear programming problem, what are its requirement? A well-defined objective function. What do you mean by objective function? I said this is the subject for decision making. A simple example, we will consider a department store where we are selling various items. We can group the items: cosmetics, food items, cool drinks, chocolates, groceries. So these are all the different items. And what is the objective of the department store? It is only to increase the profit. By selling various items, we have to increase the profit. So the objective of running a department store is increasing the profit. That is what the objective function. It is to be maximized or minimized. So if it is a department store, we have to maximize the profit, right? If you formulate the linear programming problem for stocking, then it is minimization. So we have to minimize, we need to have minimum stock to maximize our profit. So objective function can be expressed as linear functions of decision variable. What are the decision variables? The various items sold in a department store. A grocery is one decision variable. The amount of groceries is one decision variable. Right, amount of the volume of cosmetics is one decision variable. So these are all different decision variables. So any problem, it has got decision variable and objective function. And the number of constraints equation, which must be expressed as linear functions of decision variable. Why there is a constraint? There are limitations, right? For example, for a particular item, I have I have to sell minimum quantity. So we have to sell the minimum quantity to get the profit margin. So the minimum quantity to be sold, that gives the constraint to a particular item. So number of constraint, which must be expressed as leading functions of decision variable. And the decision variable must be non-negative. So it is obvious. So the product sold, it cannot be negative. So all the decision variables should be non-negative. There must be alternate course of action. And the resources must be limited. So why there is a constraint equation? It is because of the limited resources. So the OR, the operation research subject, is applicable only when we have limited resources. We want the best performance under restricted conditions or limited resources, right? So this is what the requirement of linear programming problem, LPP. So how to formulate LPP? So in the formulation of LPP, we have to identify first the decision variable of the problem, which are non-negative. So by studying the problem, studying the physical situation, we have to identify the decision variable. What are all the variables, what are all the parameters that will influence the decision of the problem? That is what the decision variable, right? Objective function of the problem, which may be maximization of profit, production capacity, maximization of production capacity, or minimization of loss, or minimization of machining time, etc. So either it is maximization time or minimization time. Constraints imposed on the problem to satisfy the limitations. So we said there are limited resources. So there are constraints. So the constraints, the limitations are expressed in the form of constraints. The objective function and the constraints are expressed as linear algebraic equations. So this is what the requirement of formulation of the procedure for formulation of LPP. Now look at the example. So clearly understand the example, then the problem, the writing the equation will become easier. A company makes three products XYZ, which follow through departments drilling, lathe and assembly. The hours of department time required by each product, hours available in each department and profit contribution of each product are given below. You read the table. I have three product X, Y, Z. So these are the three product X, Y, Z. And there are three department, drilling, lathe and assembly. So the X product, it is undergoing drilling operation for 3 hours, lathe operation for 3 hours, assembly for 3 hours. Similarly, Y product, 6 hours in drilling, 5 hours in lathe, and 10 hours in the assembly. Z product, 7 hours in drilling, 4 hours in the lathe, and 12 hours in the assembly. So this is what the time required for each product in various department of operation. Now, what is the profit I am making? So by selling X product, number of products of X, I will get 9 rupees for each product of X. For product Y, for each product of Y, I will get 15 rupees. For each product of Z, we will get 20 rupees. So this is what the profit. Now what is our objective? By selling the product XYZ, we have to make the profit, maximize the profit, increase the profit. Now what is the constraint? What is the limitations? The hours available of each department. So drilling department, the total number of hours available is 210. Lathe department, the total number of hours available is 240. And assembly department, the total number of hours available is 260. So this is the table. Read the table, understand the content. The marketing department of the company indicates that sales potential of a product X and Y is unlimited. What do you mean by that? So you can sell any number of X and Y. But for a product Z, it is limited only 30 units. So we can maximum sell, we can have maximum 30 units of the Z product. So you have to formulate the LPP. So how to formulate? So first thing, what are the decision variable? Number of product of X, number of product of Y, number of product of Z. I call number of product of X equal to X1, number of product of Y equal to X2, number of product of Z equal to X3. So X1, x2, x3. By selling x1 product of x, x2 product of y, and x3 product of z, I will be getting a profit. What is the profit? 9 times of x1 plus 15 times of x2 plus 20 times of x3, that gives the objective function. So it is maximizing z equal to 9 times. For each x1 product, I will get 9 rupees. For each x2 product, I will get 15 rupees. For each x3 product, I will get 20 rupees. So it is what the maximization. Then constraint. So drilling department, right? It is imposing a constraint on the problem. What is the constraint? The maximum number of hours available is only 210 hours. So the product X consumes 3 hours, Y 6 hours, and Z 7 hours. Now what is the constraint based on the drilling department? 3 times of X1, 6 times of X2, 7 times of X3 should be less than or equal to 210. So that is what given here. 3 times of X1 plus 6 times of X2 plus 7 times of X3 less than or equal to 210. Similarly, 3 times of X1, 5 times of X2 and 4 times of X3 less than or equal to 240. 8 times of X1, 10 times of X2 and 12 times of X3 less than or equal to 260. So these are the first three constraints. 3 times of x1 plus 5 times of x2 plus 4 times of x3 less than or equal to 240. And one more thing, the marketing department of the company indicates, so the limitation by selling the product, so product Z, that is x3, should be less than or equal to 30. So that is the fourth constraint, x3 is less than or equal to 30. Now we said all the decision variables should be non-negative, that is also indicated here. So x1, x2, x3 should be greater or equal to 0, that is non-negative condition. So this is what the mathematical equation, LPP, mathematical formulation of the given problem. So this is what the problem given. Okay, now we take another example. The products P, Q and R are being produced in a plant having a profit margin of rupees 3, 5 and 4 respectively. The raw material A, B and C are of scarce supply and the availability is limited to 8, 15 and 10 units respectively. The specific consumption details are given below. So this is P, Q, R. These are the product. A, B, C, these are the raw material and this is what the requirement. For each product of P required 2 kg, 2 units of A and 3 units of B. Q require 2 units of A, 3 units of A, 2 units of B and 2 units of C. R require 4 units of B and 5 units of C. So the product R does not require component A, material A, and product P does not require the raw material C. You have to formulate. And this is again, the profit is 3 rupees, 5 rupees and 4 rupees. And the raw material availability is 8 unit, 15 unit and 10 unit. So this is the table. We present the table in a better format. So here this is the better form. So I have the raw material ABC, product PQR. The profit made by the product are 3, 5, 4 and availability of raw materials are 8, 15 and the 10. Right? Now what is the addition variable? Number of products of P, X1. Number of products of Q, X2. Number of products of R, X3. What is the objective function? So, profit. I have to maximize the profit. So, maximize the profit 3 times of X1, 5 times of X2 and 4 times of X3. Look at here. Number of products of P, X1. Number of products of Q, X2. And number of products of R, X3. These are all the decision variables. And objective function, what is objective function? Maximizing the profit. Z, maximize Z equal to 3 times of X1 plus 5 times of X2 plus 4 times of X3. And what are the constraints? The constraints imposed by the raw material. So, with respect to raw material A, 2 times of x1 plus 3 times of x2 less than or equal to 8. E for raw material B, 3 times of x1, 2 times of x2, 4 times of x3 less than or equal to 15. And raw material C, 2 times of x2 plus 5 times of x3 less than or equal to 10. So this is what the constraint. 2 times of x1 plus 3 times of x2 less than or equal to 8. 3 times of x1 plus 2 times of x2 plus 4 times of x3 less than or equal to 15. 2 times of x2 plus 5 times of x3 less than or equal to 10. And non-negative condition, x1, x2, x3 values are greater than or equal to 0. So this is the solution for the defined problem given mathematical, given real-time product problem. Okay, coming to the third problem. A factory is engaged in manufacturing three products, A, B, C, which involve lathe work, grinding and assembly. The cutting, grinding and assembly line required 1 unit. The product A required 2 hours of cutting, 1 hour of grinding and 1 hour of assembly. Similarly, the product B required 3 hours of cutting, 1 hour of grinding and 3 hours of assembly. The product C required 1 hour of cutting, 3 hours of grinding and 1 hour of the assembly. So these are the unit given. And what is the profit? The profit of A, B, C are rupees 2 for A, rupees 2 for B and rupees 4 for C. So this is what the profit made by the three products. Assume there are available 300 hours of lathe time. So lathe is available for 300 hours. Grinding machine is available for 300 hours. And assembly line is available for 240 hours. So you have to formulate the LTP. So this is the given situation. You have to formulate. So first thing, we have to convert the information in the form of a table. So this is what the table. This is the table. So we have three product A, B, C, and it is undergoing in three machines, lathe, grinder and assembly. So product A require 2 hours in the lathe, 1 hour in the grinding machine and 1 hour in assembly line. Product B require 3 hours in the lathe, 1 hour in the grinding machine and 3 hours in assembly line. And C require 1 hour in the lathe, 3 hour in the grinder and 1 hour in the assembly. So this is the requirement of time. What is the profit? Profit made by product A is 2 rupees, product B is 2 rupees, product C is 4 rupees. So this is the profit, right? And hours available, 300 hours in the lathe, 300 hours in the grinder and 240 hours in the assembly line. So this is the mathematical equation, right? So number of product of A is x1, number of product of B is x2, number of product of C is x3. And maximize the profit. 2 plus 2x1 plus 2x2 plus 4x3. And the constraints are based on the available time. Right? Lathe 2x1 plus 3x2 plus x3 less than or equal to 300. x1 plus x2 plus 3x3 less than or equal to 300. And x1 plus 3x2 plus x3 less than or equal to 240. So this is the mathematical equation, mathematical model for the given problem. So finally, we conclude. So if you do ordinary things with absolute involvement, you will become extraordinary person. So you require the involvement, absolute involvement to be a successful person in your life. So all the best. We will meet next.